Today is October 19th and it's 8:11 right now. October 19th, 8:11. I'm about to take my son to school. So I'm not gonna go to the gym today. Yesterday I went and Monday I went, 2 days in a row. Monday I did back. I recorded it. The video's up. Yay, finally did something quick. The video's up. Yesterday I didn't record anything. I only did leg, and today I just wanna take a rest. Yesterday while I was doing legs, I didn't feel that much intensity and energy, so I said maybe I need a break. So today I'm taking the break, I'm resting. And right after I drop my son from school, I'm gonna go to the supermarket and grab some stuff. In the middle of the night, I got up and I couldn't go back to sleep, so I turned on the TV. I was watching something and I saw someone who made a salad, and all of a sudden I feel like eating salad. But this type of salad is not, you know, the lemon, lettuce and things like that. It's just, I'm probably gonna buy. Yeah, but can you be, Mark, can you, later, talk to me later, okay? Go start putting your shoes. So the kind of salad I'm thinking is I put cucumber, celery, what else was I thinking of? And I'm going to make the, you know, the dressing with lemon or lime, whichever is cheaper, that when I get to the store. And you know, those kind of thing. I'm not going to put lettuce in it. And then when I come back, I'm going to make another version, another oatmeal cookies, because my cookies, actually, I think I only have 6 left, which will be good for tomorrow when I go to the gym. So I had some bananas that I bought, and I kept them so they could get really soft, because I want the sweetness. The sugar and the banana. So yesterday they were starting to get really soft, so I did not want any flies going around. So I peeled them and threw the peel away, and I put that in the fridge. So I already have the bananas peel. I have it here. So I had kept this in the fridge after I peel it. So when I come back, I'm gonna make that. And I'm thinking of buying ground meat, and I wanted to make something. So I might record some of my cooking, but nothing major. Yesterday I did the cabbage. I was thinking of recording it, but I had so many things to do, so I didn't feel like pulling out the camera. So what I'm gonna do, I'll be taking my cell phone. So anything that I'm gonna record is gonna be on my cell phone, and I'm gonna leave my camera here. So I need to get my son to school. Now it's 8:13. And let's see what I have. So I'm gonna try to spend at least $40 or at least $50 at the store. Usually when I go, I spend more than I actually want to spend. Oh, I see something, I was like, oh, I wasn't thinking about it. So I'm gonna try to spend at least $40. Let's see how that goes. Can you show the tomatoes that your school planted? Yeah, there's a lot. They're getting big. There's a lot of tomatoes. Wow.
Wait. What about
don't pull them. Yeah, they just started.
Wait, mommy,
No, I don't want you to fall. Lots and lots of tomatoes. Wow.
I mean the biggest one.
The biggest one that I saw.
I mean the big one.
There's a big one. Yeah, there's a big one here. And there's one all the way in the back here. It's nice. A lot of them. Oh, Miss Mimi's there. All right.
Thank you.
back. This is my leftover coffee. I'm gonna drink that. Gonna warm it up. Let's put 35 seconds. So let's see what we got. Eggs. Did I prepare? Let me see. I had a list. Let me see what I did with the list. There it is. So, in the list, I wanted to buy ground meat, foil, aluminum foil for the stove, and condensed milk, cereal for the kids, eggs, cucumber, tomato, lemon, or lime, depending on the cost, avocado, and mango. So, I did not get avocado and mango. I did not get the cereal, and I was starting to put stuff and buying other things that I didn't plan on. So we already have cereal. I was gonna get just one cereal for the kids, but we already had, so I didn't buy it. And pretty much I got everything plus some other stuff. Okay, this is the foil for the stove. I bought 2 eggs. The kids love eggs. So I bought 2 eggs. Many people don't like to get those bags at the stores, but I use them for trash. I don't buy plastic bags for trash. I use these for trash. And there's the ground meat. I'm gonna make this today. There's the ground meat. That's that. What else did I get? There's the lime. They were, I think, 5 for $1.99. And the lemon was 5 for $2.99, I believe. So I got this. I only want the citrus juice in there. So I don't know why the yellow one is always more expensive than the green one. And the things that were not on the list are chips. This is for my husband. The other day I went to the store, I bought 2 for him. That's gone. So I bought 2 more for him. And this one, it was not on the list also, but I bought it for my son, my youngest. Usually after school, I take him to the library. I read at least a book for him, and I made him practice his writing. That's my youngest son. Homework. Okay.
Hello.
And they want you to put your name. The A, that's a nice A, but it's too far away from the M. Okay?
See?
Put it close.
Right here.
No, that's
that is too far, mommy. I know.
Okay, so put it closer. But yesterday the weather was very good. So two of his former classmates, the parents were waiting for the older one who gets out a little bit later. So the youngest were playing in the yard. So my son wanted to stay and play with them. So, and he asked me, he wanted to do picnic with them. So I wasn't planning to do picnic. So he was eating their stuff. So I bought this chip for him. So when I go pick him up, I had to bring that for him. I bought 2. And I bought celery. I'm gonna make that for my salad that I was thinking about. And this bread, I bought it for the kids. This was not on the list, but what happened, I've been really tracking what I eat, and this past couple days, you know, I've been feeling kind of hungry. I want to eat something, and we have no junk food whatsoever in the house. So we have Oreo cookies. So I ended up eating 6 Oreo cookies, and right after I felt bad. So I said, you know what, let me buy some Ritz crackers, and that will, whenever I feel like eating something, I'll just eat it. And there's the tomatoes. These were on sale. And these are the condensed milk. Sometimes I put that in my coffee. So yeah, where is the receipt? Let's see how much I spent. I just saw it. What did I do with it? And I bought onions. Where did I put it? It's right here. I don't want to take it out of the bag. Where is the receipt? I just saw the receipt. There it is. So I spent, okay, the balance was $48.02. So yeah, so I spent $48.02. Let's see. Let me underline it. I underline it. Hopefully you guys can see it. Sometime I don't see it here, but when I'm editing it, I see it. So I spent $48.02. So that's not bad. I sort of stick to my list. So now I'm gonna get the meat ready, put the stuff away, and let me pause this. Okay, I changed my clothes. I haven't done cooking in a while. So since I started recording this morning, I might as well continue the video. And I have absolutely no clue when this is going to be up. What time is it? So I did pretty well in terms of timing. It's 9:35. So I'm gonna put the ground meat in the pot. And usually, for some reason, on Wednesdays, the supermarket, the things that I normally buy, they aren't. I don't know if it's on sale or, yeah, they're just much cheaper. So I like to go on Wednesdays. Actually, this, I'm gonna keep it for some other trash. And I already have one over here. So, I don't know if I've done videos of how I make this, but since I'm in the process, one thing I like to do is to get all the water and the juice or blood out. This is not for vegan. This video is not for vegan, I must say. So if you guys don't like meat, please do not watch this. So I like to get all the blood and the water out of the ground meat. So I did it like that for a while. And let me lower the fire a little bit. And I'm gonna cover it. And let it do its thing. I'm not gonna, you know, every now and then I'll be checking it to see how much liquid is in there. And then I throw the liquid away and then put it back in until it's really dry. And then that's when I start putting my seasoning and stuff. So let me do the other thing I was thinking. I have no counter space. I have something right here, but I will be cutting. I'll use this bowl for my things. I'm gonna rinse this because I'm gonna be cutting things. I had taken this out because I was planning on doing some stuff. First thing first, I'm gonna cut some of this. I don't need all right now. Some pepper. I bought some pepper. I'm gonna wash it. If I want more, I'll make more, but otherwise I don't need to make too much. I only bought one pepper because I usually buy them frozen. I'm gonna save it. And I'm gonna cucumber. What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna cut the entire cucumber because when I leave them in the fridge, I sometimes forget I had them. So therefore, I'm gonna cut it off. I'm not even gonna cut the skin out. And celery. I haven't bought celery in a while. This is ridiculous. This is so horrible. I'm gonna take two of these. I have no idea how much I paid for it. I didn't see the price on it, but I wanted it. And it's Wednesday, so it must be a bit cheaper. So I'm gonna wash that. And I bought some, actually this, I wasn't planning, I sort of thought about it, but when I saw it and I said, you know what, I'm gonna get it. Because I could eat some of them when I'm sitting around. But since I bought it, I might as well put it in the pan. I'm gonna wash them again, so. This is the liquid I was talking about. I'm gonna get this liquid out. So I'm gonna keep on draining it each time more liquid comes. This here. I need the tomato. No idea what. Oh. Tomato. These were, the price was right for these. So this is it, okay? I think later on when I'm ready to eat them, actually I might cut the onions and then do it. But I wanna get the banana thing out of the way. So let me move this out of the way. My blender broke and I haven't bought a new one. So, you know, I really don't feel like doing the mashing today. It's gonna take too long. Anyway, I'm gonna pause this. Okay, while I was mashing the bananas, this is my base for the oatmeal cookies. So the ground meat, it's sort of ready. What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna leave the oatmeal cookies for a while. I don't want to be going back and forth between meat and the baking. So I'm gonna keep them separate. So I'm gonna leave that alone for a while and I'm gonna cover it with this. So now, maybe I should move this in the front. Let me move this here. And I bet, I taste one of the, baby carrots earlier, and then all of a sudden my taste bud just wants to eat more. So it seems like sometimes your body feels knows what it needs. So luckily I bought it, but I'm munching on it. I didn't eat anything this morning yet. So I'm gonna move this over here. Okay, all the liquids are out. Okay. This is where I'm gonna start putting my seasoning and everything that I want to put in it. I might have to fast forward because lately my videos have been kind of long. These are the peppers, the frozen peppers I usually buy. I'm thinking if I should put it because when my kids, you know, I could just take them out. They're so picky, they'll find any reasons for not eating certain things. So if there's pepper in it, they'll say, especially my youngest, he'll be like, oh, there's this in the food, so forth, so on. So I'm putting pepper. And this is onions. I usually buy them and then cut them and then freeze them. So this is onion, frozen onion. And these are, what's that thing? Let me see if I could grind them. Well, yeah, I can do that. Ah, he's coming. little bit. I like to grind my garlic. So that's that. So I'm letting everything simmer. I think that's the term. My thing is still a little bit frozen in it. I'm gonna try to finish as much of this before I get into the cookies. I'm gonna cover it so the thing will melt, and then I'll come back to it. Okay, well, I was waiting for this. I got some other things ready. I'm gonna be putting crushed tomato and diced tomato. I used to do them separate and then save the sauce when I make pasta, but I haven't been making pasta often, so I don't make the sauce that often. So I'm just gonna put it right in there later. But first, my usual suspects. I'm gonna put some seasonings. It's this, and I usually make sure it's mixed. Some parsley. I could have put that earlier. Let's use that side. I'm gonna start running out. I need to buy the Each of my seasoning is put individually, and I make sure they all mix in there. And some sage. I don't normally buy sage, but I bought this one. There was a supermarket that was going out of business near my house, and they had a lot of stuff they were trying to get rid of. And you know, it was there, it was cheap. I think it was probably 99 cents or something, so I bought it. Pepper, ground pepper. Some adobo. And I'm gonna put some Goya sazon, two of them. Pretty much it's done. All I need to put is put the tomatoes in there, but I'm gonna leave it for a few and then I'm gonna get back to it. So meanwhile, what I'm gonna do, while I'm gonna pause the camera, I'm gonna cut an onion to put on my thing. There's the onion. I don't want to take it out of the bag so it doesn't make a lot of mess here. Oh shoot, it's two different types. I knew it was two different type of onions, but they put them separate inside the bag. It's two bags within a bag. All right, there's my knife. Putting two different type of onions because the package that I bought has two different kinds. So I was like, why not just put both of them. That's for the salad, by the way. That, put this back over here. Okay, everything looks good. This is this. I was thinking of making two different kind of oatmeal cookies. One with my supplements in it and one without. The one without, there's a lady who works at my son's school, the oldest one. I find out she is diabetes. So when I made a potluck last year for the school, and I told her how I made the cookies because that's what I bought to the school. And you know, I sort of, I didn't encourage her to eat it because I'm not a doctor. So I sort of mentioned to her, you know, it's sort of healthy, the things that I put in it. And I said, if you want, you could taste it. So the following day, or maybe a couple days later, I saw her and I asked her how was her blood sugar after she ate the cookies. Did anything happen? She said no. So I was thinking of bringing some for her. So now I'm putting the tomato. This is the crushed tomato. Pretty much my ground meat is done. Because I want the kids to eat it. Usually if it's just for me, I'll put all sort of vegetables and stuff in it. But my kids, when they start seeing them stuff in there, they don't wanna eat it. So I'm not gonna put other things in it. I need the water and this so I could get all the leftover. Let's see if I could drain it in there. I need to get all the crushed ones out. There it is. So pretty much, this is done. And as you can see, I did not put salt in it. All the other seasoning that I put, the salt is good enough for me. Now, if my husband wants to add salt in it, in his portion, he can. This is why my kids don't like my food. There's no salt. I tried to get the taste bud yet into those type of food and stuff like that, but so this is done. I'm gonna get back to this because I want it to be done. I'm gonna move this back here since I'm done with it. I'm gonna put in lower heat, turn this off. This goes back, cover it, let it cook, and it's done. Yeah. All right, back to this. So now, this is done. Let me get I want to use a spoon that I can use when I'm doing the other stuff. I just rinsed this, so when I need to rest my spoon, I could put it in there. So let me get the things that I'm going to be putting in there. I will be putting cinnamon. It's done. And I will be putting vanilla extract and a little bit of cream of tartar. There's no need for it, this is optional, but since I have it, this is chia seed. The bag was almost finished and I had this container, so I put it in there for easier access. Chia seed. This I could put a lot. But lately I've been using it, I mix it with my rice. It's really good. And I think that's all I need from here. Now this is what I'm thinking. Should I do some separately for the lady? Which means I'll have to go to the school and bring it. And I'm not planning on going to the school today. If I make it today, maybe I'll bring it tomorrow. So I'll pick my son up tomorrow maybe. All right, so I'm mixing it. I'm gonna be putting, let me put a little bit of baking powder. And I'm gonna put, it's behind the camera, I need to get it, raisins. And this is also where some of the sugar come from. One thing I don't put is regular sugar. So I'm gonna put a good amount because I like the taste of it. So raisin is done. No space. Okay. The raisins. The main parts I didn't put yet. This is the oatmeal. Let me put all the other stuff in it, and at the end, I'll decide if I should put, if I should make some for that, for the lady. So this is ground oatmeal. I blend these to have the flour texture. I'm hoping this is enough because I do not want to blend any. I have that small little blender and I have to do a whole bunch. And this is what's gonna make it thick. The regular oats will not make it thick. And as you can see, I'm not telling any measurements how much to put because I just go by, you know, I eyeball everything. I have so many versions of this. There's some phone calls. Lately I've been thinking of doing some freelance architecture. I used to do freelance a lot, but sometimes after you do the work, they don't want to pay you. So there's one person who actually owed me about $13,000 worth of freelance work. And the reason he was able to get away with it is that my husband emailed him all the information at once. I had some issues with the computer and I told my husband to look into it for me. And right after he fixed it, he sent all the work. Everything that I spent late nights doing, and some of them I think he helped me a little bit. And he sent everything, all the work, to the guy. I was so pissed. And then after that, the guy didn't pay me. I'm not gonna chase him for money. I've survived since then. Even though the money won't be helpful, I actually paid tax on it because I knew I was gonna do it. I was gonna get paid. I actually paid tax on it, but I just never get paid for it. I did my tax, I include that $13,000, and thinking that the guy was gonna pay me. So I ended up losing in so many ways. I didn't even bother asking the government for it, for the money back. The reason I paid the tax on it, it was right around tax season. And I was doing my tax. I didn't want to wait until the following year to, or maybe later. You don't mess around with tax, let's just say. So it's something I knew I was going to get paid for. And it was around tax season, so I included on my tax, thinking that I was going to get paid, but the guy never paid me. I think this thickness is sort of good. I don't want it to be too, I'm always having some issues with the thickness of the thing. It feels kind of, I'll put two more scoops. Looks like when next time I have time, I should blend some of them. I don't want it to be too thick. So that's that. So this video, like I said, is not for vegan, but this is. Okay, now I'm gonna put regular oats. It's actually already sweet. All right, this is an old container of whey protein. But what I have in there is just, regular oats. So I'm gonna put a couple spoons of oats. See, it's oats. So technically, this is done. What I'm gonna do, maybe I'll make 10 of this for the lady at my son's school. And then the rest, I'll do for my workout stuff. All right, so I'm gonna pause the camera, get the pen ready. Okay, I sort of got stuff ready. I got my pen ready. So I was contemplating between putting her stuff on one of these, and then I realized I'm just gonna make about 10 for her, if not maybe 8 or something like that, not too much. So I didn't want, for instance, I put 8 feet into this one, and then I put my kind, because I'm gonna put supplements in my oatmeal cookies. So I didn't want to get confused. So I was like, you know what, I'm gonna put hers in this pan. I put some olive oil so it doesn't stick. So yeah, so I'm gonna put hers in this aluminum thing. So I'm gonna make about 8 or 10 on this, whatever this thing can hold. Hopefully it comes out good. And I have to remember not to put the stove too high. When it's too high, it burns quick. When I was making the potluck for the store, I had the stove kind of a bit high, I think 350 or so, and the tank burned. I had to make other ones. Whatever comes out of this one, not whatever comes out. So this is for the lady at my son's school. This does not have any supplement in it, so I'll be giving her this one. Okay, let me lower the stove. I don't want any. Now, I got hers out of the way. I'm gonna put the supplements in there. Creatine. I'm gonna put about spoons. They didn't put a scoop in there. Two of this. This is what gave me the energy. And recently I find out that, if I eat it too much after workout, I have the belly. So it's just pre-workout, 2 before I start working out, and maybe 2 post-workout. BCAA. This, doing this like that saved me a lot of money, because I don't have to keep on putting them into my drinks. So the more you put them into your drinks, the faster it's finished. So by mixing them in this cookies, not only I get full, and it pretty much saved me money. It doesn't finish quick. This is my protein. The other container that I had, was when it finished, I put the oatmeal in it. Actually, this one is almost finished. I haven't made smoothies in a while to use these. So this is protein. So this is why I just eat these after workout. You know what? I'm just gonna use everything. It's a little bit left anyway. There. So pretty much this is my part, my version. So the lady that I'm gonna give the oatmeal will not have this in hers, but mine does. Is it? I will assume these supplements will be good for her, but you know, I'm not a doctor, I'm not a personal trainer, and this is supplements. You know, supplements doesn't have any regulation. Is not like FDA approved them or anything like that. So anybody could put anything in it. And I am aware that the lady has some medical issue, diabetes. So I do not want to mess with supplements. And she did let me know. So the things that I gave her has supplement in it, if something happened to her, I don't know. But at least the things that I'm gonna give her, the cookies that I'm gonna give her, is just natural stuff. So you just if anything were to happen, you just have to blame Mother Nature. I bought the banana, the raisins, whoever make the raisins, she knows, she could see, she will be able to see the raisins, so she could make her own judgment if she should eat it. What else did I put then? Vanilla extract, those other ground cinnamon and things like that. So this is, she can make her own judgment. All right, so I mixed it. This is my energy booster. So here I'm gonna put, let me use this one fresh because it's bigger. I had to tie my hair. I don't want my hair to be frizzy from all the steams and stuff. The main thing that I really wanted to get out of the way was this, and hopefully the kids will eat it. Yesterday I made cabbage and other things. My husband liked it. The kids did not eat it. They just look at it. They didn't want to eat it. They're so picky. But I think once they get older, they'll know the reason for it. Because my oldest always asking me to do exercise. So if he just keep on seeing the things that I do, he'll catch on. I don't want to starve him because he's not eating the way I'm eating. Once he gets older, he wants muscles, he wants to do this, he wants to do that, then perhaps he'll get the hang of it. But I don't wanna starve him to death. Even though some of the things that they're eating are not healthy, but they have to eat. I limit them on some of the things that they eat. Very good. Okay, this goes in there. I don't know if I'm gonna, this is the, I put the olive oil in there and then I sort of use this to spread it a little bit more. Put it in that plate for later. See how much that will go in there. Sometimes I put other things in there. Next. Okay. Put it this fit in there. That's a little bit big. I have to be careful not to get too much of it. That's it. Okay. So now we're kind of done. That's it. While I was cleaning up, put things away and things like that, I came across this apple that my youngest son's teacher gave to him. She always, when there's foods left over, she usually tell him to take it, because the school, for some reason, they throw them away. And it's crazy. So this is something I like to do with this, with these type of apples. Since I was a kid, I never liked these types of apples. I don't know why. Well, some other kids might like it, but. So, sometime I do it with the skin. I'm probably gonna put the skin separately. You're gonna see what I'm gonna do. The reason I'm doing this is because I have things in the stove. I'm gonna bake it. So what I usually do, there's no particular ways of cutting them. It's just because I don't like these apples. The one, when we go apple picking, since I'm the only one who eats those apples and I give them away, I usually make them pick the apples that I like. See, I take all the good part within the apples. This I do. Alright. Now, what I usually do, I'm gonna put a little bit of sugar. I wasn't planning on doing this, but this, I came across the apple. A lot of cinnamon. And that's it. You know, mix it all, make sure they all, the sugar and the cinnamon mix. And then I coat the apple with it. I did put some olive oil in the pan, so it doesn't stick. Damn it, looks like I'm gonna have to make some more cinnamon, and the others already took everything. I thought that would have been enough. Yeah. So a little bit more sugar. Only for this type of apples. You could do it with any, a whole bunch fell in there. Okay. Like this. Okay, it's not quick. Just take part that did not mix in. I did say I want a lot of cinnamon, but not that much. I could even do the skin. Whatever can go in it. Sometimes I leave the skin and thing with the apple. And then put it in the stove. So now that my hand is clean from the meat, the cookies I just finished, now I'm getting back to the salad. I sort of clean everything already. I washed this, they're still dripping, so I'm putting this underneath it. I just warm up the coffee again. So this is the lime. This one was cheaper. I didn't care. It doesn't matter to me if it's lime or lemon, and I consider them the same. So this is what I'm gonna do for my dressing. Okay. I have this. did work, but still does its purpose. For some reason, I'm not in the mood for it right now, but I'm gonna get this ready when I feel like eating it. I'll just grab it. See, I could have done this before I turn on the camera. I'm gonna put a little bit more. Once I open it, I leave it in the fridge. That's a little bit too much lime juice. But it's okay, I probably will use it tomorrow too. This is just for me, not for the kids. So, done with this. This is how much lime juice I got in it. That's a lot. And I am going to put my favorite thing, cayenne pepper. This is for me, it's not for anybody. I'm gonna kill it with cayenne pepper. And soy sauce. Anything, I could always add more. Onions, things like that. So that's it. I'm gonna leave it in the fridge. When I'm ready to eat this, I'll take some and put it on top of it. Actually, I'm gonna leave the spoon in there. That's it. So my son, who wants to have a picnic after school, normally I take him to the library to do some work, but yesterday the weather was nice. I sort of mentioned it earlier. So he wants to stay after school to play in the yard with the kids, and he wants to have picnic. So when I went to the store, I bought this. So I'm gonna bring this. And goldfish. I'm gonna bring three goldfish, maybe four, just in case, one for each of a boy and a girl he will be playing with, including him. So I'm bringing four, two for him, one for each of the other kids. And I'm gonna bring two Capri Sun. Let me put them in a bag. What is this? Cucumber. So I have another bag, but all right. So the chips, Capri Sun, goldfish, and he wanted Oreo cookies. So I'm gonna, we have a box of Oreo cookies. If I taste one, it's over. So I'm gonna bring three Oreo cookies, one for him and one for each of the kids. Yesterday I only had one, so I made him share this with the other kids. So now each one of them is gonna have their own. I wasn't planning to stay after school to play with them. So it was a spur of the moment, and the weather was nice. Sort of changed my plan because I wanted him to be at the library, practice his writing, and read a story for him. But the weather was nice. So at the spur of the moment, it ended up to be a nice little thing. The kids, they play well together. And they were in the same class last year. They're not in the same class anymore. So we used to see each other, we say hi, and we became not good friend, but just we are nice to each other. Let's just say that. So I'm gonna bring this to the school, and he could, you know, have his own thing to eat. He was sharing chips with the other kids, so now he has his own. So checking the cookies, actually. This is done. I think it's good. That's the other one. Yeah, I think this is done too. that's the one that I did for her. This is the, check it out, the apples. This one was on top. I'm gonna put it on the lower level. I don't think her cookies is ready. I'm gonna leave it a little bit longer. I'm putting this inside there because I think this has a hole in it, and then I'm gonna warm up my potatoes, my sweet potatoes. Put it right back in there. Oops, this. So these are good, I think. Either way, it's good. Everything is done now. I should have turned it off a while back. I was on the computer doing some stuff. This is actually overcooked, but it's still soft. It's not. Luckily, the thing wasn't that high. So everything is done. I'm a little bit hungry. That's why I'm here. I'm gonna put this right back. I turned off the stove, but it's still warm up. I'm gonna just let this sit in there to get the warm. But this one is good. This is the sometimes I leave them really crisp. Oh, that's the apple I made. So that's like a snack. But I'm kind of hungry. Actually, I'm just gonna leave them in there. The stove is off. I just don't want to. These are good. I don't wanna do anything with that. So it's about 1:30, and then a few, it's gonna be time to pick up my son, and he wants to have picnic with the other kids. So I wanna eat something. So what I'm gonna eat is that salad. So since I sort of prep it earlier, okay, all the water that I cleaned it with dried out. So I'm just gonna throw some in. The peppers are at the bottom. That's good. I don't need all right now. And I'm going to have this. That's the lime juice with onions and cayenne pepper. So I'm just gonna, that should burn my lips. Actually, later on when I'm eating, I'm gonna sprinkle this on my rice. And if I eat some of the meat that I made this. I'll sprinkle that also. So that's about it. I'm gonna put this back in the fridge. So that will be my snack. I really didn't eat anything today, so that should keep me up for a while. That's all I wanna eat. I've been thinking about that in a while. It's gonna be very hot. Hit the spot. That's exactly the taste I was going for. So now, it's about 2 o'clock. I changed my clothes. I did some stuff. I'm about to go pick up my son, but I wanna stop at the library first. So I wanted to show, this is the sweet potato. I make oatmeal cookies out of these, but I forgot I put cayenne pepper in it, so I didn't wanna mix it. So I'm gonna eat some before I go. And then everything else is all set. The only thing I need to make when I come back is rice for them. But since I'm about to leave, I don't wanna make them and then leave the rice cooker on. Because my son wants to have picnic with his old classmate. So all the cookies are done. I don't wanna eat it. I taste one already. And this is the one I'm gonna be giving to his, I think it's a security guard at the school. She's very nice. She's diabetic, so she can't eat a lot of sweet stuff. So this is just natural stuff. And mine, I put different things in it. Hers is just banana and things like that. So everything is done and I'm off to the library, because today I'm not gonna go with my youngest. But I need to return some books and get some new ones. So that's my day. You know what I want you to do? When you're doing this stuff, I want you to take it easy, okay? You wanted to have the picnic. Did you enjoy the picnic? Mm-hmm. Say yes.
Yes.
All right.
Then no. I don't know how to make the
turtle. Look at me. Look at me. I don't like the way you're talking to me. Understand? So take it easy. Follow the lines. I'm talking to you. Follow the lines and you'll be okay. You don't need to do the dot. The dots were for you to follow. Okay, that's E. Can you make the R? Small R. And stop getting your attitude. You're learning. Okay, I did what you wanted. That's good. All right, make one here. Try to do it on the dotted line. A straight line and then turn at the dotted line.
I know.
Okay. So you don't know.
It's a straight.
Look. Mark, please look. A straight line, right? And then from here, you turn here. Okay?
Give me that.
I'm telling you, I don't like your tone of voice. Make it smaller between this line, the dot and the red line. Stop there, okay? From the middle, turn. Make it touch the dotted line. Go over it. Because you did it so small. Up. Okay. Turn. Yes. And right, make it darker. You want some chicken?
I made it darker.
It's looking better.
Wait, I
want to
do something.
Okay, let me eat.
Wait, don't see.